So I, this idea of writing, and you know, you could have done other things.
I did do it.
You
I did
did.
everything.
All right. Tell
I
us
did
a,
everything.
and that must feed the writing. And that's something that's, I think, important about writers.
Well, you know, I didn't start making a living as a writer until I was 45 years old.
Ah.
That's a long time, especially when I published my first book when I was 30.
Okay.
So it's a long haul. And before that, I was a house painter. I was a moving man. I was, you know, a word processor. I was a legal secretary. I was a bartender. I was a singer, songwriter. I mean, ridiculous, everything I did. You know, I remember being a moving man and pulling a refrigerator upstairs in San Francisco.
It sounds like Laurel and Hardy.
And I'm going, I don't want to do this anymore. You know, I'd rather do this. This would be a little more fun.
Yeah.
But I always knew I wanted to be a writer, but, you know, trying to find a way to open that door and get published and be commercial.
So every one of those people you just mentioned, all of them you, have got to have become characters in the books.
Well, yeah.
Right?
Well, I mean, Dismas Hardy himself, the first book when I brought him to the screen, as it were, or to the page for the first time, he was a bartender at the Little Shamrock Bar in San Francisco, where I had worked. I mean, I had worked as a bartender.
Okay.
And he lives on 34th Avenue, where I had lived in the exact same apartment. And you know, you write with what you start with what you know, and then you build on that in creatively. And so Hardy was me basically when I put him down on the page. But within two pages of the very first time I talked to him, or he talked to me, he was a different person. He was his own person.